Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel, Asad International Academy. Today I'm going to clearly explain that how to find the quartiles Q1, first quartile, which is also called as lower quartile, second quartile, and third quartile, which is also called as upper quartile. So without wasting any time, let's solve the lecture. First of all, the x data is given here and terms are given here, first, second, third, up so on, 16 terms. So here n, which are the number of values, is equal to 16. So first of all, I'm going to calculate first quartile. The put 16 plus 1 over 4 th, 17 divided by 4 th, which show that 4th term, 5th term, 6th term, you can write here 17 divided by 4 by using calculator, we will get here 4.25 terms. Now you can easily write here 4th term plus 0.25 bracket, next term will be here 5th term minus 4th term. So here 4th term is given here, 2 is the 4th term, so here, right here, 2 plus 0.25 bracket, 5th term is given here, 3, I put here 3 minus, and 4th term is here, 2. Now, you can easily calculate here, 2 plus 0.25, and 3 minus 2 will be here, 1. So here, 2 plus 0.25, we will get here, 2.25. So here Q1 I have calculated here, the Q1 is here 2.25. I hope that you are clear the point that how to calculate the first quartile. Now I'm going to calculate second quartile. So here 2, similarly you can easily calculate here 16 plus 1 divided by 4 th 2, and we'll add here 17 divided by 4 th, and 17 twos will be here 34 divided by 4 th, and next 34 divided by 4, which is equal to 8. By calculator you can easily get here 8.5 term, and next you can write here 8th term plus 0.5, just like that, and next term will be here 9th term, next term is here 9th term minus next term will be here 9th term minus 8th term. 8th term is given here 4. 4th is the 8th term is given here 4th. So right here 4 plus 0.5 bracket, and next term will be here 9th term is here 5. So you can write here 5 terms minus, and 8th term is given here 4, and now you can easily calculate 4 plus 0.5, 5 minus 4 will be 1, you will get there by easily calculate Q2, the value is here 4.5 value Q2, and next Q3 you can easily calculate here 3, so 16 plus 1 divided by 4 th 3 bracket, 17 over 4 th, 17 3 is available here, 51 divided by 4 th, and next you can easily calculate here 51 divided by 4 will be here 12.75 terms, and now next term will be here 12 plus 0.75 bracket, and next term will be here 13th term minus 12th term, and next 12th term is given here 8, you put here 8 plus 0.75 bracket, 13th term will be here 8 minus, and 12th term, and 12th term is given here 8. So now we'll get here 8 plus 0.75, 8 minus it will be 0. So here Q3 I have calculated here, so here Q3 I have calculated, which is the value of 8. I hope that you are clear the concept about that, how to find the quartiles Q1, Q2, Q3. Also share this lecture with your classmates and friends so that they also have a benefit of it. And don't forget to like and subscribe this video. Goodbye.